President Trump has been trying to undermine confidence in mail-in voting. The Department of Homeland Security now warns that he's not the only one pushing that message. John Avlon with a reality check.
It's happening again. Russia echoing Republican talking points in an online disinformation campaign designed to help Donald Trump. But this time, the Trump administration is in power, and it's trying to hide evidence of that influence operation from you, the American people.
Now witness the revelation that the Department of Homeland Security suppressed an intelligence document in July, showing that with high confidence, Russia was pushing allegations about the poor mental health of 2020 presidential candidate Joe Biden.
Now, this came in the wake of Trump campaign ads arguing the exact same thing, a line of attack they've only ramped up since. It hit kind of a snag after Trump bragged about passing a mental fitness test.
You go, person, woman, man, camera, TV. They say, that's amazing.
But pay attention to the apparently conscious parallelism of the Russian and Republican attacks, because we've seen this before in 2016, when Russian trolls and the Trump campaign both tried to suppress black turnout. Now, in October of 2016, the Trump campaign was using Facebook ads to discourage black Americans from voting. And at the same time, Russian trolls were posing as African-American activists on social media, pushing messages encouraging folks not to vote in protest or to vote third party. But President Trump's response has been to dismiss it and take Putin's word over our intelligence community because he benefited and expects to do so again, which might account for Trump's silence or indifference on a series of recent Russian provocations, including putting bounties on U.S. troops to poisoning opposition leader Alexei Navalny. Because in early August, counterintelligence officials warned that Russia is once again trying to help get Trump reelected and feeding bogus information to Republican investigations into Joe Biden.
And then, the new director of national intelligence, John Ratcliffe, stunned Congress by announcing he would stop in-person briefings about election security, citing unspecified leaks.
Now, yeah, that's the same Trump-defending former congressman who promised the Senate that he would always present the unvarnished truth. Combined with the suppression of the DHS report, it's hard not to see an administration that's trying to use the power of the federal government to advance the president's reelection by hiding information from the American people. This isn't just unethical. It would seem to be in violation of the law, specifically Section 6507 of the National Defense Authorization Act, which requires the DNI and DHS secretary to brief Congress within 14 days of an assessment that a foreign power is trying to interfere with our elections. This is exactly the kind of scenario that law anticipates. But tone comes from the top, and the Trump administration too often acts like the law doesn't apply to them, knowing that by the time this is litigated, the election will be over. But don't forget, the federal government ultimately works for you. You have a right to accurate information about an assault on the basic integrity of our elections. National security should always be nonpartisan. And if it feels like deja vu all over again, as Yogi Berra once said, remember, this time, the Republic is at stake. And that's your reality check.
Our thanks to John Avlon for that.